As the U.S. Federal Reserve held interest rates steady and hinted at just one rate cut this year, the projected quarter percentage point reduction is expected as late as December. Now, the Fed earlier hinted at three rate cuts this 2024, but it has since been reduced amid rising concerns on how to keep U.S. inflation in check.
Stated that we do not expect it will be appropriate to reduce the target range for the federal funds rate until we have gained greater confidence that inflation is moving sustainably toward 2%. So far this year, the data have not given us that greater confidence. We'll need to see more good data to bolster our confidence that inflation is moving sustainably toward 2%. We know that reducing policy restraint too soon or too much could result in a reversal of the progress that we've seen on inflation. At the same time, reducing policy restraint too late or too little could unduly weaken economic activity and employment.
While rate cuts are likely to start late and proceed at a slower pace at that than what investors had anticipated, the Fed's policy rate is seen falling fast next year with reductions of a full percentage point in both 2025 and 2026. Fitch Ratings sees the Philippine Central Bank cutting its key rate by 50 basis points this year, down from its initial projection of about 100 BPS. Now, the BSP, in its latest monetary policy meeting, held its benchmark rate steady at near 17-year highs and is expected to do the same when the Monetary Board meets later this month. Now, the credit ratings agency attributes the revised projection to the possibility of the Fed delaying rate cuts and the weakening peso, which has been trading at near 2-year lows in recent weeks.
We were forecasting for the BSP to cut by 100 basis points for the entire year, you know, starting from June this year. You know, but I think that's not going to happen. We right now, given what's happening in the domestic market, the inflation rate, and how the Fed is looking at their own interest rate trajectory, we are baking in a much slower interest rate cuts locally in the BSP. We are baking in about 50 basis points for the rest of the year, backloaded in later part of the year. If they were to cut so much faster, then you know it will stoke some risk to the inflation. Risk to the peso depreciating much further. And if that were to happen, then it will have a repercussion on the cost of imports and eventually the inflation rate. So I think because of that, we don't think that even if they were to cut, they will not be cutting very aggressively, at least for this year.
Expelled Philippine lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. now under house arrest in Timor-Leste as he awaits his possible extradition. Adrian Ayaline joins us with that story. Adrian, go ahead.
Yes, Sandy, the Department of Justice confirmed report that former Negros Oriental Representative Arnolfo Teves Jr. is under house arrest in Timor-Leste. Asked to confirm the also what they heard from Timor-Leste. The DOJ extradition proceedings are still ongoing. Vasquez said that regardless of whether to be rearrested or on house arrest, he is under the control of the police authorities. Vasquez emphasized that, simply put, Teves is deprived of liberty. Local websites in Timor-Leste reported about the house arrest confirmed by Teves' lawyer, Attorney Ferdinand Topacio. Topacio said that after having determined that Teves is not a flight risk and that he thought he was placed by Timor-Leste authorities under guard in his residence, simply in the hearings. Back to you, Stanley.
All right, that was Adrian Ayaline reporting to us, getting a choppy signal there, but basically was telling us that Arnolfo Teves Jr., the former congressman, is under house arrest in Timor-Leste, but his lawyer, Attorney Ferdinand Topacio, is saying that authorities there had determined to put him under guard, just under guard, as he is not a flight risk. The former congressman is also waiting for the processing of his extradition to the Philippines.